Everyone in the world is currently using these Instagram story templates. And surprisingly, I found myself insanely interested in seeing if someone prefers peanut butter or Nutella. Also made me realize how insane people are, because why would you prefer breakfast over dinner? But these templates are often a bit basic. So I made my own for your using pleasure. First, I made one to test your intelligence. How smart are you? With questions like, should a bee be able to fly according to all known laws of aviation? Yes or no? Do you watch Rick and Morty? It's kind of the only test you need, but still. And of course, how long can someone survive without breathing? Yes or no? And then there's a what do I use, get to know me kind of thing, where people can underline something they use or strike through what they don't use. For example, do you use a Windows phone or a BlackBerry? If you have this burning question and you need to know the answer, do you prefer to search on Bing or Ask Jeeves? And after a long day of Instagramming, how do you connect with your friends? Do you hit them up on MSN Messenger or Kick? I always like to see what someone thinks represents themselves. So there's emoji madness, where you have to put the emoji that best represents you in the white circle. But I took the liberty upon myself to fill it in for people. And then there is a vision test. You see this stock image and you get 3 lines to describe what you see. The answer, of course, being someone who stupidly left the white background in a PNG instead of making it transparent like a normal person should. Then I made one, and as the title I put get taggin' with a comma instead of a G, because I'm a genius at wordplay. My hair isn't the only thing that me and Jimmy Neutron have in common. So this one is actually pretty standard. Tag your best friend. Tag your favorite teacher. Then tag your friend who is most likely to defecate in the bushes when no one's around. And then of course we circle back to tag your friend who is most likely to defecate in the bushes when there are people around. And then tag your siblings. And then lastly, you see a lot of these have I done it, with a whole list of things people could have done, and you can check whatever you've done and people can see how wild you are living your life. Stuff like gone skinny dipping. Have you ever shoplifted anything? Overthrown the government. Ditched school. Dyed your hair. Died. Had a dream come true. Cried yourself to sleep. And lastly, cried someone else to sleep. So I put them out there, put them on my Instagram stories, put them as one of those highlights in case you also want to use it. Of course, tag me. People have filled them out, and I of course have their amazing answers right here. Should a bee be able to fly according to all known laws of aviation? And he says, no, because bees are letters. Do you watch Rick and Morty? The ultimate test to see if someone is an intellectual. No, I'm in my 20s. It's a good show. And that kind of says that you don't get the humor and sheer subtlety of the- How long can someone survive without breathing? Yes. The eye test. What do you see in this image? A sad depiction of animal shelters in the United States. Unwanted puppies are turned into shoes. What do I use? He doesn't use Windows phones or Blackberries. He only uses burner phones. Hey Siri, what's a burner phone? To search, he of course uses Ask Jeeves, and to chat, as everyone does, MSN Messenger. Best friend. God. His favorite teacher are the trees, because the guy who filled this in is, in fact, the Lorax. Friends most likely to defecate in the bushes when no one's around? All. Friends most likely to defecate in the bushes when people are around? All. All of his friends, every single one of them, are equally likely to defecate in the bushes whether or not someone is around. No siblings. I also told the people on Twitter about these templates and if they want to do them, to which Sam Adrians told me the exact scientific reason of why bees are actually able to fly according to all the laws of aviation. Emoji madness. No, you're not supposed to put it over the emoji. It was pre-filled in to save you all on some work. You're welcome. And from all the things he has ever done, he died. Now yet someone else didn't understand the emoji madness. Makes me wonder why the octopus represents you, but it was a pre-filled in template. Guys, let's see how smart this person is. Should a bee be able to fly according to all known laws of aviation? Yes. Well, since, what was his name? Sam already pointed it out. Do you watch Rick and Morty? Ah, no. Okay, yeah. I could have only had that question in there. How long can someone survive without breathing? No. And then in small it says, how is this a yes no question? Oh, there's a 90% chance that only I think this is funny. And then lastly, for the eye test, she said, a dog in a blue shoe. There's two options, very big dog or very big shoe. Wouldn't very small dog be the other option? If it was a very big dog, wouldn't the shoe look small? If you also want your followers on Instagram to know who you are and to learn something about you, you can check out my Instagram at Quinten Hyde. Check out my highlights, screenshot those templates, and be sure to tag me, because of course I also want to learn about you. Please comment down below, what other questions should I have added. And if you want to join our nice little community here, you can of course subscribe to this channel. I post a video every Wednesday and Saturday, and I do all of that because I want to light up your day and be your friend and connect! But above all, I really hope you enjoyed this video as much as I did, and I would love to see you next time.